Hello and welcome to The Big Picture. The long and arduous journey to create a legislative framework to ensure food security to the people of India is still not over. Though the scheme has been inaugurated today following the issuing of ordinance last month, the passage of the bill in the parliament continues to take time. The bill, which was expected to be passed today in Lok Sabha to replace the ordinance, has got stalled and is now expected to come up on Thursday. Meanwhile, more amendments are being sought by various parties, while the government itself has moved certain amendments. There are still voices both within the parliament and outside expressing dissatisfaction over the provisions and demanding more amendments. We will look at what are the hitches still in this landmark legislation, which is expected to be a game changer, both in terms of ensuring that no one goes hungry in the country, but also in political terms. To discuss this, I have with me D. Raja, CPI MP in the Raj Sabha, Bhakta Charan Das, Congress spokesperson and MP in the Lok Sabha, Dr. Sanjay Jaiswal, BJP MP in the Lok Sabha, and Biraj Patnaik, Principal Advisor in the Office of the Commissioners to Supreme Court on Right to Food. Welcome to all of you. First, let me go to Mr. Raja. Mr. Raja, you know, by and large, I think you and the left parties have been in favor of this kind of a legislation. I'm sorry, I think there's some problem with Mr. Raja's phone. Can I go to Dr. Jaiswal? Dr. Jaiswal, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay, Dr. Jaiswal. By and large, your party has also not been really against this legislation. But in the recent week or so, there seems to have been certain differences between your party and the government on this legislation. What are the major things which your party is opposed to when it comes to the ordinance which is already in place?
See, the first thing is that the amount of food grains allotted has become less. Previously, we were giving 35 kilograms per family.
Right.
Now, if you suppose that the family consists of five people,
right.
Now with the new bill, they will be getting only 25 kilograms of the food grains. Then it's very partial. If you are giving rice, but you are not giving pulses, there are so many other flaws also. And the biggest flaw is that still in India, the poor has not been decided that who are poor people. Saxena committee gives another report. Tendulkar committee has a different opinion. Our planning commission has got entirely different opinion. The state governments has got another opinion. And the issue of who are poor people has been left on to the state. There should be a uniform level, who is poor and who is not. Then only we can succeed in giving these food grains to the poor people. So on one hand, we agree with that food grains should be provided as a right to every person. But there are so many flaws in bill which need to be get corrected.
Dr. Jaiswal, if I remember correctly, this bill has been through several processes, including the standing committee and all. Your party were not able to convince the standing committee about all these factors?
No, but you have to define who the poors are. It hasn't been much discussed in the standing committee. First, you have to decide who the poor people are in India. And there should be a uniform level of poverty in India. It's not like that a person who is living in Punjab has got different kind of poverty and a person living in Bihar has got different kind of poverty. So first, the most important thing missing is how to define poor people.
Okay.
That should be absolutely clear.
Okay, let me get Mr. Raja in. Mr. Raja?
Yes.
Okay, Mr. Raja, your party is also, has fought for this kind of a legislation. It has been backing all this kind of legislations. But you and the left parties also seem to have certain reservations on the ordinance which is in place now. And do you think that you have been able to sort out these differences with the government? Or do you think there are still certain issues which have still not been decided?
You are right. We are for a legislation, a strong and effective legislation on food security and right to food. The CPI and all the left parties have conducted a countrywide campaign on this demand. But the bill which is before the parliament in its present form, with its present content, is not acceptable to us. That is why we have been demanding there should be a comprehensive debate in Parliament. This bill needs to be drastically amended. Now, we have given several amendments to this bill. What we try to emphasize, number one, the public distribution system should be streamlined, strengthened, and universalized. This legislation should not lead to dismantling of public distribution system. Number two, in the past, we could see the division of APL, BPL, which was so defective and deceptive. We have been saying no question of dividing like this APL, BPL. Now they are talking about targeted, general, all these kinds of things. Then we have told to begin with,
yes,
every family should get minimum 35 kilograms of food grains at an affordable price of a kilogram per 2 rupees to begin with. Then we have been saying since beginning, no question of cash transfer. And you can't replace the supply of food grains by giving some kind of coupons or cash. This we are opposed. So then there is one more serious issue, that is there are different states which are implementing almost universal public distribution system. For instance, Tamil Nadu.
Right.
The Tamil Nadu government is giving 20 kilograms of rice, food grains, free of cost, no charge. And the Tamil Nadu government has ensured the people can go and buy a kilogram of rice for 20 rupees in open market. And there the public distribution system is almost universal, covering the vast sections of our society. It can be said about Kerala, Andhra Pradesh, Bengal, even for that matter, Chhattisgarh.
Right.
Now, this legislation should not affect these states, and no state should stand affected, because Tamil Nadu government has raised a very serious issue. That is, if this legislation in its present form is passed by the parliament, Tamil Nadu will lose, Tamil Nadu will stand affected, and it should not happen. Then it will affect the financial federalism, economic federalism of the country. All this will have to be taken care of.
Okay.
Even in case of scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, there are various suggestions. You can leave out those who pay income tax or those who are propertied in those sections. But otherwise, the scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, all people should be covered by this legislation. So when there is a debate, we can discuss all these things.
Okay.
But Parliament is not...
Parliament is not functioning.
Sure that is exactly the point.
That's the problem.
That is exactly the point. And why government went through ordinance route, we can't understand on such an important issue. Why government went through ordinance route? Government could have come before the Parliament, and government could have asked the Parliament genuinely, we want this bill, this legislation, which is for the common cause and public purpose.
Right, Mr. Raja, let me... I think there is a problem with... I would like Bhakta Charan Das to answer to some of these points raised by these two members. But I think... Bhakta, can you hear me? Okay, I'll come back to Bhakta later. Biraj, some of these points which are made, I want you to clarify a few things which raised by these two members of the opposition. See, they are saying that it will come down from 35 kilos to 25 kilos. Is it a fact?
Well, yes, that is true. That for a certain section of people, we used to earlier call below poverty line, it will come down from 35 kilos to 25 kilos.
Right.
And this is something that the Right to Food campaign and all of us, in fact, it's violative of Supreme Court orders.
Hmm.
Because Supreme Court has said that BPL must get 35 kilos.
Right.
However, the Antodaya Anna Yojana, the poorest of the poor, will continue to get 35 kilos. Now, I want to make a slight point here. I think one has to take a larger perspective on this legislation. Today, Government of India gives
Biraj,
food
grains. Biraj, I think we have got Bhakta Charan. Let him first clarify some of his position. I'll come back to you. Bhakta Charan, can you hear me?
Yes, brother.
Okay. Bhakta, you see what the, some of the points raised by both Mr. Raja and Dr. Jaiswal. You know, from what they are saying, it seems that the government has been in a major hurry to get through this. Mr. Raja even asked why ordinance had to be issued. Some of the points raised by them, many of them are very serious points. Why did the government have to hurry it through like this and without a larger consensus on this issue?
Whether this came in 2009 that there has to be a food security bill.
Right.
Thereafter, the government of India adopted several procedures.
Right.
9 times the GOM was sitting. And the state level ministers and departments of food civil supply were consulted 3 times. The standing committee took 1 year to finalize, and more than 70 suggestions of the standing committee, which was represented by all political parties, MPs, was incorporated in this bill.
Right.
And thereafter it came in last parliament. At that time they made a lot of hue and cry and the bill could not be passed.
Right.
And this time you might have observed in the television that all opposition MPs, they started supporting that we want to support, especially the major opposition. They said that we want the bill. But today you have seen, we have witnessed the situation in the parliament. One day could have been avoided, this bill could have been passed. And the other day, rest of the things could have been raised.
Right.
But it has not happened. The question is about the BPL category. Is not going to be affected to this food security bill.
One of the major points being made by both of them is that the allocation will come down from 35 kilos to 25 kilos.
Look, at this moment, the government of India is giving 35 kg to each BPL in the entire country.
Right.
Okay. But the state governments are giving somewhere 20 kg and somewhere 25 kg. The government of India at this moment, as per the price, 27 rupees kilo rice. And the government of India is giving around 23 rupees subsidy amount for that. And the state governments are giving 2 rupees somewhere, and they are giving in 1 rupee, and they are giving somewhere in Tamil Nadu.
Bhakta Charan Das, the larger point is that that there is no consensus, that there doesn't seem to be a consensus, despite you said that 2009 this whole process started. You know, even after 4 years, we still don't have a consensus. Why is the government in such a hurry to push this bill through?
You see, the government cannot entirely agree as per the capacity of the government. The government is facing so many challenges within and outside. You know it very well, and every intellectual knows, and everybody in the panel knows it very well. But thing is that once a certain bill is being made, one person consumes 5 kg rice. And if somebody, family is there, they are having 10 members, they would get 50 kg. Somebody is having 7 members, they would get 35 kg. And five persons, each family is the general trend in our country. So what is the harm? I do not understand. Is this the thing that basing on this will disturb this bill?
Moreover,
67%, just a minute, 67% population of the countries are going to be benefited. So what is the BPL criteria over here? It is going to operate much beyond the BPL criteria.
Bhakta, I think Mr. Raja wants to intervene. Yes, Mr. Raja, quickly before I go to Biraj.
Ideally speaking, a family of 5 members should get minimum 50 kg of food grains. But considering all the difficulties, the left parties have said to begin with, there should be minimum 35 kilograms of food grains available for a family. When I say this, I also add one more element.
Yes.
That is, the nutrition part should be taken care of.
Yes,
in India, that is one of the biggest problems.
Absolutely.
And this legislation should address that also.
Okay. Biraj, two things. One, what they're talking about. You're talking about the larger context in which we need to look at it.
You know,
and also, I want you to address this calorific and nutritional security.
No, I think there's no doubt that it should be 35 kilos. But if you look at the larger picture, every state is going to gain. Right. Virtually every state is going to gain financially. Some states are going to lose food grains as well as financially. And I think
when you say some state, these are some major states you're talking about.
Major states you're talking about, like for instance, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu. Because what is now happening is that when you use the headcount ratio, or use whatever ratio and allocate it, the existing allocations that they were getting, which was, we've always had a southern bias in our PDS.
Right.
And after the APL quotas were done away with in 2005, the amount of food grains from government subsidy that, say, Tamil Nadu receives is 5 times per household as compared to Jharkhand.
Okay.
Now, there has to be a time, point in time when these inequities have to be adjusted.
Exactly.
But one way of doing it, I think, and I would appeal to the Congress party to consider this in order to get this legislation through, is to say that we will freeze the allocation for those states which are losing out at the current level.
At the current level.
That is very much feasible.
So that at this point of time, they don't lose.
Maybe in future. And they can say that we freeze it for now.
Right.
And then we can look at production might go up, these states might procure. So that is one way of addressing it. I think the more serious concerns are that this program of community kitchens that has been knocked off.
Right.
I would appeal to the government to bring it back. Look at the success that Amma kitchens are having in Tamil Nadu.
Absolutely.
Tremendous idea. Third, what Mr. Raja said, which is very correct, that the nutritional component needs to be brought back or at least strengthened. Supreme Court has said all 6 services of the ICDA should be within the ambit of the bill. Fiscal cost, 0. Bring them back. Supreme Court has said ban private contractors. Fiscal cost, 0. Please ban private contractors to make it corruption free. If you look at the opposition amendments, there are 260 amendments that have been made. Almost 60 to 70 amendments are common to all political parties.
And the government is also willing to...
Yes, and I think that is important. I think now the spirit should be to get this legislation through. It has many shortcomings, but we will address it. We should address it over time. Let this be a small step in the right direction. And I think government should accede to some of these demands, and I hope they do.
Yes, Mr. Raja, quickly.
No, I agree with him. Good sense should prevail upon the government. And government must concede certain crucial, valuable amendments that left parties and other parties are proposing.
Right.
Everyone wants a legislation.
But legislation
should be effective and strong one. And he has talked about community kitchens also.
Yes.
In Tamil Nadu, there are Amma restaurants. Perhaps
right.
You must have heard.
Yes,
and Tamil Nadu is one state which is a leading state.
It's a model state. It's almost
family planning is concerned.
Why should that state lose out?
Yeah.
Okay.
One small point, before we come, you know, about the BJP. Frankly, I am a little disappointed in the BJP because the outstanding model in this country that you have of the public
is
Chhattisgarh,
right,
which is a BJP state.
Right.
The tallest leader in the BJP today is on food security is Dr. Raman Singh.
Yes.
And yet you have Mr. Narendra Modi going around saying, you know, there's a Gujarat model which is not there. So I think the BJP has missed a major opportunity. Their demand as articulated in their parliamentary party
and also Narendra Modi's letter to the Prime Minister.
We are completely ludicrous. You know, what they should have done is stuck to their guns and said, Government of India should introduce the Chhattisgarh model because that is the best model that is available
to us. Dr. Jaiswal, don't you think that, you know, instead of talking about the
Can I speak now?
Yes, please.
Thank you very much. First and foremost thing is that what we were opposing, that there should be 35 kilograms at least for a family. The second thing which I would like to say about Mr. Bhakcharan Das ji is that what you want to give the message that have 20 children so that you can have 100 kilograms of food grains. There should be certain criteria. Is it a crime to have 1 or 2 children so that you will get only 20 kilograms, and if you are having 20 children, then you can have more than 100 kilograms of food grains, and then you will be happy. This should not be a criteria at all.
The second thing
Mr. Bhakcharan Das ji said, let me complete first.
Yes.
The second thing he stressed that it's a 4 years old idea. The 4 years old idea was also that bringing back the foreign money to India.
Once
you are increasing the prices of fertilizer by saying that we have to reduce subsidy, And the second part is that you are increasing subsidy.
Dr. Jaiswal, you are going away from the topic now. Let me get Bhakta Charan Das in. Bhakta, two points.
It's all corroborative. You can't separate it from other topics.
Let us separate
these topics from here. What happened today in Parliament, we wanted to talk about food security bill.
Yes.
But we asked the Prime Minister to come in the Parliament.
Dr. Jaiswal, please. Bhakta, please respond to some of the points which has made. One is that, you know, is the government and your party willing to make these adjustments, make these compromises? And, you know, there are 60, 65, 70 amendments which are common to all political parties, including some of the issues which have been raised here. Do you think the government is ready to accommodate all that?
First thing is that no party in government, whosoever may remain or had driven in government, would agree to whatever the opposition would say. Because the political parties, opposition parties, it seems that they are not committed to this food security bill, which is going to give benefit to the 81 crore population of
Bhakta
the country.
Bhakta Charan Das, I think, you know, we can avoid.
It is wrong to say.
Bhakta Charan Das,
sorry. Committed.
Mr. Raja, one minute. Bhakta Charan Das, I think, you know, let us keep the, you know, trying to make political points out here. Please address the issues which have been raised. Like Biraj mentioned three, four issues which should be conceded by the government. Do you think the government is ready to concede them?
You see, more than 2 crore 43 lakhs population, those are poorest of the poor, are going to be benefited out of there. The pregnant mother and lactating mother and the children condition in the country is well known to
Bhakta Charan Das, that is not the issue. The issue is about these 4 or 5 points which Biraj raised, as well as Mr. Raja and Dr. Jaiswal. Is the government willing to concede some of them?
Let the debate happen first. Nobody allows the debate in the house.
One more thing, Bhakta, I want you to address this. Mr. Dr. Jaiswal's initial remark that, you know, we are still not clear who the poor are, how they'll be, you know, who will decide how many poor are there. Is that issue is still seems to be pending? We have been discussing this for the last several years.
Sir, that's a different debate, that who the poor are. 67% population and 81 crore are going to be benefited means much beyond the BPL category. The BPL category is not applied. The Planning Commission said that on the expenditure part only, the suggestion whatever has been given, 27 rupees or 33 whatever is. I have nothing to comment on this. What is the food security bill? Whether it is warranted for the nation? Whether we all feel it seriously or not?
One second.
Okay. There is no doubt that everybody feels seriously. Yes, Biraj.
I think, Girish, I want to clarify. Because there is a lot of confusion.
One
is the estimation of the poor. Right. Now, in India, there has been a lot of confusion on the estimation of the poor. That has been settled by this bill.
Yes.
This bill says 75% of the population will get it.
Right.
So, it is not linked to the poverty line.
Okay.
Whatever Planning Commission may come up with, it doesn't matter. Because 75% of the population will get it.
Right.
That is insofar as estimation is done. For identification, now there are two things. The bill is saying that state governments will identify. Because when, you know, Mr. Jaiswal said, Dr. Jaiswal said, why isn't it that center should have uniform criteria?
Yes.
In the bill that went to the standing committee, there was a uniform criteria. But then parties felt that, no, this is an assault on federalism, it should be left to the states.
Right.
So it has been left to the states.
Right.
However, the central government should have completed the socio-economic caste census.
That is right.
Where the exclusion criteria could have been clearly applied. There is still not time lost. They should do it. They should, you know, Mr. Jairam Ramesh should take it up on a war footing. But I think he does not want to take responsibility of this exercise before 4 states go into polls.
Right.
So they are delaying it. But central government should really conclude the SECC.
If the census becomes the criteria, then there will be uniformity
Absolutely.
Across the country.
Now so there is no problem. Yeah.
Mr. Raja, do you think the census will be able to bring about this uniformity in the country? Because right now, each state will then decide, in, you know, what will be the criteria, and there can be a lot of confusion, confounded.
No, already there are several states which have been doing this. I pointed out Tamil Nadu is implementing
right.
an effective public distribution system. And Chhattisgarh, I concede that point, that state is doing well in this regard. Kerala, Andhra, Karnataka, Bengal, all these states are doing well,
right.
relatively better.
Right.
What I am trying to say, what Congress party has done is something which Congress party will have to introspect. With political and electoral considerations, Congress party brought an ordinance.
Right.
The bill is pending for a few years. Why Congress party did not show that will, that determination in the past to discuss all the issues across the board and build a consensus to have a proper legislation? That is the point.
Mr. Raja, 4 years have gone. Yes, Biraj, quickly.
The answer to that is very simple. Because the Congress party, there is a very large section of the economic right, both within the Congress and with the BJP, which has been opposed to the bill. Except the left parties, the economic right in all politics. You see, the biggest problem
Absolutely.
That the Congress party has had is not with the opposition. It is the internal opposition of the cabinet,
Mr. Prime Minister, the finance minister, which has led to this delay. Mr. Bhakta Charan Das, last words to you. We're completely run out of time. Do you think by day of tomorrow, there'll be some kind of a consensus? And then once the discussion takes place, there will be some amount of consensus and this bill could be passed. I will get both the other two MPs also to respond to this.
Today Haryana, Delhi and Uttarakhand
yes.
have started this food security bill.
Right.
And along with that, some of the states, they have added dal with that.
Right.
So the states are free to do whatever they want to do. But the centers, whatever is able to do, 600 million ton production at the moment.
Right.
And we have, we will manage around 17, 20 million tons further required. And
okay.
we are having such food stock.
No, that is not the point. The point
so we
is
can manage
the,
it.
The point so, is, the one second, let me get Mr. Raja. Mr. Raja, do you think that the opposition will also accommodate some of the demands which the government has, some of the problems which the government has, and by day of tomorrow, do you expect the Lok Sabha to pass this bill?
No, the problem is the Congress party and the government should be accommodative.
Okay.
It is not that opposition parties are irresponsible.
Okay, Dr. Jaiswal.
No, let me finish.
We are completely out of time, Mr. Raja.
Let me make a final point. And they have started this scheme in Delhi, Haryana and some other state. Why? Without the approval of parliament, through ordinance they want to do
okay.
it. That
yes,
shows
yes,
the political
consideration
of the Congress.
You have a point, Raja. Yes, yes, Dr. Jaiswal, very quickly.
Yeah, I will give just one example of amendment. Till now, we were providing THR as a wholesome food to the girls and
small
children.
We can't. We don't
now,
have time to discuss that.
Dr.
Jaiswal,
they should have freshly cooked bill.
Okay,
I agree with
that. Okay, on that,
so
I think.
We are not providing wholesome food after this bill. We will be not.
We will. Okay, we are completely run out of time. Sorry, The kind of discussion which is happening here in the studios indicates that there are still a lot of things which needs to be sorted out. Hopefully on Thursday, we will see a debate in the parliament and all these points will be raised and the government will also take note of them and accommodate some of these concerns. And hopefully we'll have something to see in concrete terms on Thursday. Thanks to all my guests, Mr. Raja, Bhakta Charan Das, Dr. Sanjay Jaiswal, Biraj Patnaik. Please keep watching. We'll come back with another big picture same time tomorrow.